Okay, good morning. Today we are going to exchange rate. So here we want to look at how to change from one currency to another. For example, from Ghana cedis to Naira, from dollars to pounds, and so on and so forth. So we have these two examples to enable us to achieve that objective. Now, the first question says that we should convert 800 to rupees, to Indian rupees. Can you see that now? But according to the conversion factor here, there is no direct link from dollars to rupees. So, but there is a link between the dollars and the pounds. So what we just do is convert the dollar to pounds, and then from pounds to rupees, because there's a link between pounds and rupees. So what we do is, now, if you have $800, $800, what will it be in pounds? So that means we call that X. So we use letter X to represent that. Okay? Now, the conversion factor says £1 equals to $1.7. So what we do is just cross multiply. So we have 1.75x equals to this 800, we multiply 1, that's 800. Now, divide both sides by the coefficient of x. That will be 1.75, then 1.75. This one will cancel this one out. Okay? So x will be equal to 800 over 1.75. And the answer to that question, you can do it manually, or you can use your adding machine to do it. So that will give us 457.14. And then we have other numbers there that we can add if we want to. Okay, so this answer means $800 is equal to 457.14 pounds. Alright. So the next thing is we want to convert from this pounds to rupees. That's the next thing. So we have here that £1 equals to 100 rupees. £1 equals to 100 rupees. So what is now 457.14 pounds in rupees? So we call it X. We call it Y, because we don't know it. So the equivalent value is called Y. Now, here the next thing you do is just cross-multiply. So it will be Y equals to 457.14 times 100. And that will give us 457.14 rupees. So this is more approach, okay? So we can see that $800 is actually equal to 45,714 rupees. Okay, that answers the first question. All right, let's move to the second question. That is conversion from Ghana cedis to Nigerian naira. So what we just do is here now we have a trader who bought a computer for 256,000 Ghana cedis, right there in Ghana. And then, why he got to Nigeria, look at it here, he said he was asked to pay 20% of that amount as import duty. So what you just do is, if you want to know the actual amount the trader paid, okay, on the computer, it means you must calculate this 20% and then add it to that. So it means 20% of this amount of 2560 will be equal to 20 over 100 times 25600. Then you must add it to 25600 because you must add it to the main amount. So this one, we cancel this one out. This one, we also cancel this one out. So if you multiply this now, it will give you 0, 2, 10, 11, then 5. Then if you add it to 25600. Okay, that will give us, that is 51200. So that will be 002703. So this is it. This is the total amount paid on the computer from Ghana. So convert this one to Nigerian naira. So it's simple to convert this to Nigerian naira. That is 0.05, okay, CD equals to 1 naira. So what is this amount in Nigerian naira? So that will be equal to 307200 equals to X naira. So if you multiply this, if you cross multiply, that will be 0.05x equals to 307200. Okay, divide both sides by this value, then it means x equals to 307200/0.05. So in fraction, 0.05, convert it to not common fraction, it will give you 5/100. Okay, so that means x equals to 307200 divided by 5/100. That will be equal to 37200 times 100/5. So that will be equal to this here and this here 20. So you multiply this value by 20. 307200, okay, times, that's 307200 times 20, which gives us 307200 times 2. That will be 000416. So this is it. The amount the person will pay in naira. That is 6144000. So that is the whole thing. Have a nice day.